I'll let you close it up then. You'll lock it up. Perfect. How about it?
Alrighty. Here we are walking onto the aft deck. This is where the dinghy would mount. They have a pole that comes right out of the boom, extends out, and would lift the dinghy right up here onto this aft deck where there's chocks that mount right here where the dinghy would lay onto. And then the forward point of the dinghy would be here, and the forward chocks are right down here. So this is where the dinghy sets. Then you're coming up into the cockpit. This is, we're looking at the traveler winch right here. This is a manual traveler winch, where our main sheet and general winches are located here, and these are all electric as well. These controls right here are for the forward jib, and then on the opposite side are for the inner staysail. Here at the helm, we have all of our lights, our bow thruster control, our windlass control, our throttle, and kill switch button here. It's a really nice, solid, high gloss, varnished teak cockpit table. So walking up on the foredeck, these are our winches for our main halyard, spinnaker sheets, and so forth. They all get led here to the base of the mast, and this is an electric winch with a manual winch just forward of that for backup. We have the self-tacking inner staysail track here, and then up forward, we have the electric jib furling unit here with a full anchor system. Just below this hatch, we're looking at the forward sail locker where they have additional fenders to be stowed, halyards and so forth. And forward in this compartment, you can see the torpedo tube coming down from the deck. This is our chain locker. So you have access to the chain locker from that location as well. This is another large deck hatch here that's off to the side. This is where the propane tanks would go for the stove. And this is its additional fortress anchor that he has with Road. This is where it would be stowed as well. As you can see, we have the spinnaker pole here. It is a four spreader mast. And our mainsail to the shelf boom system that we see. These are hydraulic vang along with hydraulic furling gear that you see up forward. This is the dodger system that we're looking at here, how it integrates, and this top forward bimini, where if you wanted to, you'd be able to have side curtains that would attach from here and lead down to this custom track that's already built into the cockpit, as you can see here where a bolt rope would go into. You have lots of lazarette locker storage, all on gas shocks throughout. Just a really nice overlay of the vessel. Here's the forward GPS and B&G instruments here for the cockpit. Coming down into the nav station pilot house, we have full electronics. And when you're at the helm seat here, you have full 360 degree view around the vessel. Down below here, this is where our generator controls are, all of our breaker panels. This is where they're located, so centrally located, easy access if anything fails. And this is a really nice bench seat that we're looking at with a contoured footrest that you see molded into the wood. Here to starboard is the dining table. Really nice wraparound table. And couch seat for a nice lounge area. We have a built-in fridge here. And behind this compartment is where the flat screen television is located. He has a Sony stereo, CD changer, Pioneer DVD system, and VCR built in here. Coming up into the galley, we go to a different floorboard system. And we have a trash compactor, Corian countertops, double stainless steel sinks, a four-burner stove and oven, a freezer compartment that's located here that goes deep, far back into the area, and then a top-loading access to the freezer as well from here. And this is our fridge unit, opening door with good shelving and storage throughout. Just across from us is a dining room table and here in the galley. This drops down and can convert into a bed. And then now we're going into the forward bunk. It's a really nice size bed here, lots of bookshelves throughout, hanging locker storage, cabinet space throughout, and a vanity or desk area. And then its own private head and shower. Above the head, this is where the washer is located. And then on this back side is where the dryer is. Walking back through the vessel, you can see throughout the whole vessel, there's phenomenal handhelds overhead, throughout walking you down into the banisters. I mean, they really thought of a lot when they constructed this vessel. Coming up, this is double bunks here with a full-down Pullman berth. You have stereo controls that you have speakers in each room, and you have controls that operate that. As you can see, this detailed woodwork, hanging lockers, storage, and its own private head and shower here as well with a walk-in shower and seat. Now I'm walking across the hall. This is going to be our engine room. Our engine room has a full workbench here. We see the Northern Lights generator, master volt generator down below that, and the Caterpillar engine mounted below here. Now we're coming into the aft master stateroom. This is the head and shower and up forward. Nice seating area, hanging locker storage, full desk, and a queen size centerline berth with storage and cabinets throughout. Well, this concludes the video walkthrough. And if you have any other additional questions about this, please feel free to contact me at any time. 619-507-4416. Thank you very much.